Okay, I got the carburetor rebuild kit. Picked this one up at O'Reilly's for the VW thing, the 1600 that's in here. It runs terribly. And, well, I'll go through it in a little bit with you, but we'll see if we can make it a little better. I'm assuming it's just because it sat for a couple of years with ethanol gas in it a couple of times. It sat for like 6 months one time, and I'm sure that wasn't good for it. And it just runs rough. It doesn't like to start when it's hot, which that could be a vacuum advanced distribute issue too. I don't know. But we're going to start with cleaning out the carburetor, because anytime I touch... prop this. The screws here on the side, the big one you're supposed to be able to take out, put them all, you put both these screws all the way in and take them out three times is where you start, is what I, that's what I read. I don't know if that's true. But anytime I touch that bigger one, you know, it has to eat all the way in or it dies. If you back it off even just a little bit, it dies. So either it's not going in all the way because there's gook in it, which that could be the problem. Which there's moisture on there. That's obviously the humidity out here. But yeah, if I go somewhere and it's hot, I get the engine hot and I drive it. If I shut it off, I can start. It'll start fine, like within the first 5 to 7 minutes. If you let it sit for 10 to 15 minutes, it'll take 30 seconds of cranking to start every time. And then, but if you let it sit for, you know, 5 hours and totally cool off again, just the first bump of the starter, it starts. So something when it's hot, it does not want to start. Only after it sits though. Like I said, it'll start right away. You can shut it off when it's hot and it'll start right away. But not if it sits. Okay. Where do we want to start? I don't even know what's what. We'll just start taking things apart. Those are Phillips in the back, and the front ones are standard slotted. Some kind of a tag on it. Doesn't look too dirty down in there. I mean, there's obviously some crap. Probably should have opened this and made sure that the parts look right. This is the one that if I even touched it, it would die. that's a lot better. Boy, that's a big improvement. That's crazy. Definitely got a fiber washer on it. This thing comes with two copper washers in there. Washer fits. But looks like there's a new part in the kit for it. Holds that little diaphragm in. I'll put that real close before I pull it out of there. That has to go. That should have just come out. Pretty dirty. Thank you. dirty and worn. I don't see any tears or anything. I got the jets cleaned out. I think that's probably good enough. That's probably what my problem was. I don't want to take too much apart on this that I don't know what I'm doing. I just replaced the obvious parts. Okay, I got it back on and I think it's all hooked up right. I'm gonna try to start it. There's no gas in it at all, so the fuel pump will have to push some fuel through it. I mean, worst case scenario, it catches on fire. Let's see what happens. Running way smoother than it had been. That's impressive. Okay, start it up. Give it one little pump of gas when you do that. Rev it up high. Car's running smoother than it has. It has more power than it has had recently. Local hill up here that I have to usually actually drop down to third gear in it to be able to climb to its 45 mile an hour speed limit. I was able to do it today at 45 in fourth gear and didn't lose any speed. I previously hadn't been able to do that, so I definitely have more power. It's running smoother. Still needs a full tune-up now, but I think a lot of the issues that I was having have been corrected. It's still not quite 100% right. I got to go through and fine tune it and tweak it a little bit more, but just after the initial setup, it's doing much, much better. I couldn't believe how much crap came out of those jets when I cleaned them out. How many 60 pound bags of concrete can you haul around in a Volkswagen thing? Well, I have 10 in here and it did just fine. So I'm guessing you could probably do about 20 if you loaded them a little differently, put a few on the floorboards and... That's a lot of weight in there though, man.